Collector both interested me and bored me the most compared to other books we read. I have so many mixed feelings, I don't even know where to begin. I really enjoyed reading through the mind of a not-so-obvious protagonist. I mean, when you read the back of the cover, you don't immediately assume you're going to side with Clegg. You do, however, think you will root for Miranda. My experience met neither of those expectations. Clegg, while seriously disturbed and a kidnapper, has a fear of not being liked or understood, which I and probably almost anyone can relate to at one point or another in their lives. I mean, all throughout the book, he just keeps on saying, I'm so much better than any other kidnapper. I did it out of love. I wouldn't hurt her unless it is necessary. Once she gets to know me, she'll understand me and like me. Well, any sane reader knows how delusional he is, but at the same time, probably hopes some of it is true for his sake. Despite this sympathy, though, there is no escape from knowing the entire time that he's just really a naive kidnapper who sees nothing wrong with the way he's treating the objects of his love. On the other side, you have Miranda. She should be the person every reader sympathizes with, yet I kept finding myself wanting Clegg to just shut her up. She has no mind for herself, yet is one of the most conceited characters, especially for a victim, that I've ever come across. Her entire narration is some variation of GP's thoughts. It was brought up in class that she was one of the first feminist characters that people actually paid attention to. That thought actually scares me a little, that women who read this could see her as a role model. She grew up, got educated, and allowed somebody to put down all of her accomplishments and then tell her what to think. She basically became a young female clone of GP. That is the opposite of what women should do when trying to become empowered. She was so unlikable as a character. When she tries to seduce Clegg, while in many ways it's a bad thing, she is owning her body, which is very progressive of her. But behind all of that, she is inviting Clegg to objectify her more and more. Again, this story confuses me so much. By far, it's the story I was most interested in and had the most interesting premise. But I just kept thinking while I was reading it, this could have been so much more effective if... For such a promising idea, I just think it could have been executed more effectively. Now, I'm sure this is because I'm reading 50 years later, and I have been taught my entire life about empowerment and reading progressive novels. It makes sense that this book seemed predictable, because I've been exposed to so many innovative stories like it since it was written. I just wish I could experience the literary thrill and accomplishment when it came out so that I could enjoy it as much as I wanted to. I just wonder what changes, if any, Fowles would make now to help turn The Collector into the timeless work of art it really has the potential to be.